the Young Turks Mentors.
It's now time to call on our first speaker for the evening. He started his career at 17 with sales, had some stunts with media, figured out stuff while doing his engineering, and then went on to start his first startup around loyalty cards. Later, he also launched a web TV production, India Vibes, and a third startup, Salt Mango Tree Marketing Communications, which is now part of the Lynx Group based in France. A regular TEDx speaker, it gives us immense pleasure to recognize Andrine Mendes as a Young Turk mentor and invite him on stage to open the evening.
So I've been, introduced as a serial entrepreneur and all that. So to put it this way, my first two companies flopped big time. So it was a big failure. And as they say in Malayalam, this, you know, you fail twice and maybe the third one works out. That's definitely what worked with me. An entrepreneur is someone who solves a problem of tomorrow, today. So you look at any of the startups or innovation that has disrupted our world, right? It's all ideas, all products, services that can fix probably a issue of tomorrow. Now, a couple of years back, we never thought about, you know, a radio and mobile app, getting a cab via mobile app, right? But now we all do that. We can't get out without an Uber or an Ola. So it's disrupted our life in a different way. I'm just going to share how we can make this journey much more easier. So you have a product idea or your service, but why are you doing it? Why are you starting up? You're not starting up because, no, I can't work under anywhere, or I didn't get a job, or because I saw this cool idea. No, that's not why you're doing it. So the first point, or the first part of our journey, is you need to find out why are you doing this. Now, if you ask me that, okay, you know, I started my company because I accidentally got into entrepreneurship. What's the story in that? Nothing. Once you know why you are doing this, the next big important task is building a time machine. Because for the issues that we have today, people have already found answers. You don't need to again relook at it. Maybe in some way, but the ideal thing is to go ahead in time and then relook at, okay, you know, how can I solve a particular issue? When you walk into your startup and, you know, talk to a client, the first thing he notices is anything visual on you, right? I wasn't rich, I was very poor. I was a normal guy. But I used to dress up myself and walk into a 5-star hotel thinking that my client would pay for the coffee. That's how I would work in. But the level of confidence, that also depends on how you carry yourself. Are you having the latest gadgets? Are you having the latest shoe or your accessories or gadgets? These are small little things which we wear, which people also see, and we feel ourselves, okay. What I'm trying to say is, to transcend yourself ahead, you need to start doing small little changes in your life. Very small little. That might be different for different people. For me, it was about how I dress, how I use gadgets, how I think, or what people see. Moving ahead, we are in a world where you can't do everything yourself. You might have a brilliant idea, but you don't know how to execute it. What I'm trying to say is you might have an awesome idea, but finally, you need to have collaborators. Even with your startup journey, there might be things you might need to collaborate with. You need to be more open. The age of where, okay, it is my idea. So I used to have startups who used to come. I used to ask, what is your idea? See, I can't say that. That's a secret. So that age is gone. It's not about what your idea is. It's about how well you can get it executed. And for that, you need to do it in a pace where you need to collaborate. In general, foreigners say that Indians have three answers when you ask something. So normally there is a yes or no, right? For Indians, there's something else. It's called theek hai. So there is a yes, there's a no, but this is middle. You say theek hai. What I'm trying to say is, as a startup, as an entrepreneur, you might not know everything. Right? You might not be an expert in everything, but it's okay. When you get an opportunity, grab it. Say theek hai. Okay, I will try. Let me see it. Just give it a shot, right? Give it a shot and learn on the go. Going forward, go lean. Now, this is something Indians do brilliantly, and especially for people in Kerala, they are amazing at it, right? Going lean. Don't look at, you know, okay, I'll earn so much of money and have so much of bank balance and then I'll start doing this, which is not going to happen. Learn to go lean. Just start with whatever you have. Don't wait for the numbers. Moving forward. Now, this is one important part of everything that you do. Okay, so you have an idea, you have a team, you know why you want to do it. You're going to go lean. All that is fine. But people need to visibly see that you're moving forward and you have something. So this part is one of the most important things, the showing off a bit, right? Now, I'm not saying you have to lie, but what I meant is fake it until you make it. You know, you see yourself 3 years from now, start projecting it. Live that life, right? You're all startup, you have idea. So how do you start things? First thing is you explore. Internet has a lot of tools. Next step, before you start up your own, it'll be awesome if you can intern for free for other startups, because you need to figure out stuff, right? That can happen here. Look at the good things that's happening around. Absorb it, use it. You don't need to reinvent it, right? So you're running a company, you'll have 5-10 different processes. You don't need to make it from scratch. You just need to look what is happening already there and use it to your for benefit. And finally, pay forward, right? So if you're asked to speak at your college event or at your school event, that's what how I started in terms of my speaking experience as well. Go share. Maybe you're good at web designing. Maybe you're good at getting people to speak. Go share and speak. So pay forward. That's all from me. Thank you.
Startups is not about raising your valuation or getting a lot of money up front. I think a lot of people, and I've seen a lot of this mistake in the past, which is a lot of people think about, I want to get my valuation higher, I want to raise as much money as possible. No, that is not what you should be doing.
The Young Turks Mentors.